My name is Anoriell, and welcome to my channel. Here we do reactions on BL and GL content, mostly from Asian countries, but sometimes from other parts of the world. Today we're diving into a new series, A Couple of Mirrors. And it's actually a cis man's because it's from China, so it's censored. But I haven't read the original novel, but apparently it's a GL novel. And I'm really excited about this. I heard about it a couple of months ago, but then I forgot about it. But then I saw Thofer, I think, reacted to the trailer. And I was like, oh yeah, that one. I wanted to watch that one. So here we are. I hope I can put it up on YouTube. It depends on what platform it was released on. Because I know there is one platform, I won't even name them, because if I do, I will get slapped, more or less. But yeah, there is one platform, and unfortunately a lot of Thai BLs is gonna use that platform now. And it's gonna suck, because we can't react. That, you know, they don't like it. So if it originally aired on that platform, I'm not gonna be able to put it on YouTube. But if it was any other Chinese platform, probably, I hope. I did a little quick YouTube search and saw that there was one other reactor who had this up. So I'm here for hoping, guys. But yeah, it's a drama from China. And it's the Republican era of China, and I know very little about that era, to be honest. And in Chinese history, I know like this much of Chinese history, so I'm not quite sure what was going on in China during that time. And I'm not sure if we will get a good representation of what actually was going on, or if we're gonna get, you know, this is what we want you to think was going on during this time version. Because I know China does a lot of that, every country does a lot of that, you know, fixing history by censoring and stuff. Yeah, so I'm not sure, but I'm intrigued. And I want to watch it. And I loved Killer and Healer. The Killer and Healer. And this kind of gave me the same vibes. So we're diving into it. And I hope it's good. And I talk to you afterwards. Just the intro has me already intrigued. This song is really good. Shanghai, okay.
喂，小姐，你要戴哪副耳环？阿婉，哪副好看？这副。嗯，这个也不错啊。听我的，你戴这副好看。好吧，你总是对的。
哎，幼姨，这次新书的销量真的是太火爆了，你们过来看一看，这都是读者寄来的信。阿婉功不可没，先别着急夸，再看看我精心为你准备的礼服吧。嗯。
Some fun, maybe.
Was it her that ruined the dress?
丑鬼子，气死了！你看，是他做的，谁知道呢？没想到你还有这一手啊！若不是因为你啊，我早就成为中国的这一男人了。节目都要开始了。
我希望许幼仪小姐能上来帮我一下。我吗？那是你啊，行啊，行啊。我有点担心你哦。
Why do I get a feeling something will go terrible wrong and she will put be the blame. Or I don't think she did it on purpose, but people will blame her. I guess.
Yeah.
周先生，这是一场暗杀，凶手在锁伤做了手脚，其余的我们会继续调查的。太危险了，若是那个人再丧心病狂心，我太太岂不是要跟着遭殃？请你们务必要查清楚，我跟你们宋局长打过招呼了。
How did you know though? Because you came running from somewhere.
阿恒，你替我送阿婉回去吧。不用了，你不舒服，让周恒留下来陪你吧。我叫个黄包车就行了。
不行，外面天黑了，又要下雨了。你一个人走，我不放心。
阿恒，那好吧，我送他回去，很快就回来。
嗯，
六爷，你先上去休息，不要多想了。
I have loved like every piece of clothing in this so far. I wish I could rock all of those clothes, but I don't have the figure for it. But the styling of this show is beautiful.
Xu Youyi小姐会见。 初次来信，确确唐突，然无胸中有一桩难事萦绕于心，焦虑万分。本月初二，南山路桥东旅馆，周恒先生与女子亲密投诉，言谈神色，关系匪浅。此乃我亲眼所见，思来想去，特殊此函，千寻有尽，寸中难泯，还望许小姐珍重自身。你的忠实读者。
So your husband is cheating on you. Good luck getting a divorce in like, what is it, 1920 something in China. Don't think that will happen. And it seems like you are the one actually earning money. I don't know what your husband does, but
他用这种手法作案，就说明他的目标非常的明确，所以你不用害怕。Or
was it you? No, it was your husband, right? Yeah, it was your husband. But I think.
Yuyi，你怎么还没睡啊？
你去哪儿了？这么晚才回来？
车子坏了。
送去修了。
好大的烟味
儿。Yeah.
等太久了，有点不耐烦。
He went to a club.
我先去洗澡，你睡吧。
这是沪上丽人刚推荐那款香氛吧？上海还没有卖的呢。你是从哪里搞到的？
是王司长刚从香港带回来的吧？
聪明。
邓小姐啊，我拜托你件事儿，以后啊别喷这么重的香水。我这回家以后，我夫人会误会我的。你闻闻，你闻闻。
很好闻，
不重啊。
还不重？
就闻，就闻，
我
重。
我还得回家呢，别闹，别闹，别闹。
多
香、啊！大家聊什么呢？这么高兴啊？
哎，
周主任，
哎，周主任，
快坐，快坐。
是这款雪茄吧？烟气细腻，入口顺滑，持回也很不错。
嗯，尝尝。
嗯。哇，高级啊！怎么样？哎。
嗯，的确是好东西，
的确好东西，
是不是？
好东西。
接着下，接着下。
这烟味道好浓啊。
嗯哼，
今天玩的可开心了，我下次还要再来。
好，
拜拜
拜拜，
走啦，拜拜
拜拜。
Yeah, it's probably 40s, right? 30s or 40s.By the looks of the cars, I need to find out when Republic era actually was, I think. Now she realizes he uses the cigarettes to cover up the smell of perfume.
他明明在家门口抽的烟，为什么要骗我在修车？难道也是为了遮盖身上的某种味道？
周恒先生与一女子亲密投诉，此乃我亲眼所见。
太太，这是今天的报纸。
谢谢。
Is that your husband?
What?
真的，我感觉周恒在外面有女人。
放松点儿，来，喝点儿，尝尝，
又一夜。你是不是太多心了？就凭在门口捡到几根烟蒂，还有不知道谁恶作剧寄来的一封信，就怀疑周恒背叛你啊？
那不是恶作剧，我感觉他说的是真的，我的感觉不会骗我。
好，那你告诉我，你觉得那个女人是谁啊？
Her，
楚惠子。
啊？
I don't think it's
就是楚慧子，
是和
谁？他们以前是同学。
I think it's her。
可是我没听说他们认识啊。
但他们有机会认识啊。
哎，好了好了，你别瞎琢磨了，交给我调查好不好
？No, it's her。
你能查到？
当然。
那你要保证，
你不会偏袒他，不会骗我。
你说什么傻话呢？我是你的朋友，发生这种事情，我当然站你这边了。
Even if you're cheating on her husband with...
但是你得答应我。
Yeah. No.
在我没有调查出结果之前，你不能轻举妄动。明天还拍照呢，要保持美美的心情 ，OK？ 嗯。乐爷，你知道吗？其实你能走到今天，周恒太太这个身份为你增色不少。很多人都盯着你看呢。无凭无据的，你可千万不能自乱阵脚，嗯。我知道了。好啦，这酒不错的，尝尝。干杯。好啦，不许多想啦，路上注意安全，大家记得给我打电话啊。来，慢点，慢点啊，拜拜。
Husband?
他走了。
Yeah.
怎么办？他怀疑了。
怕了。
我早就说过不要出去约会。上海他认识我的人那么多。
怕什么啊？他说交给我调查，我说什么他都会相信的。
你真坏啊。
嗯哼，
你怎么那么会编故事啊？你应该写书才对。
我也想啊，可是我没有一个在内政厅做部长的公公，也没有一个年轻有为的交通厅主任做丈夫呀。
那年轻有为的交通厅主任做你的情人如何？
Called it.
你呀，昨天答应我什么了？
我什么都没答应。最喜欢的花色，嗯，有品味的店。
这店里老板也不在啊。
在。这店就你一个人？
对。
老板挺年轻啊。
有事儿？
我们是来拍《沪上丽人》做宣传的照片的，之前打过电话预约，记得帮我们右移拍美一点哦。
好。
Oh, she's jealous.
借过。
啊，不好意思。
She seems to be equally jealous, the photographer.
下来。真美。我要坐下吗？
坐那吧。来。
你们夫妻俩拍一张吧，好久没拍照了。
当然好，我的荣幸。
幼姨，笑一个。
来，
我们三个一起拍一张吧。
好呀。
Yep。
都站好了吗？
啊。
来，一。
Now there is photo evidence.
前面等着呢，时间定了吗？
定了，请悠悠姐先到九号厅参加发布会，然后十二点结束以后，由陈编辑约在雨花厅进行情感访谈。
Why？
啊？
嗯？
哇哦！
我先去大厅，动作快点。
She ruined it. She's, yeah.
许小姐请。许小姐您才刚结束完新书发布会就能过来参加访问，这是辛苦你了，十分感谢。
不客气，这次发布会十分成功，也很有赖各位媒体朋友的照顾。
许小姐您客气了，那我们现在就开始访问。
嗯。
徐小姐，您对当代社会的夫妻关系怎么看呢？
感恩、愤青、理解。
哦，愿闻其详。
感恩这个时代，它让男性与女性都变成了独立的个体。
嗯哼。
女性不一定要再选择依附于谁，而愤青是属于自己的。你当激励自身。完善自身，而不是去把期望加注于丈夫、父母或者子女身上。
那理解的含义？
理解是对你身边那个人理解他，相信爱的时候是真正深刻的爱，但若是出现了问题或是单纯的不爱了，也该有潇洒放手的勇气。
您说的实在太好了，非常感谢许小姐提出这些精彩的观点。
你呀，不要跟记者瞎讲什么放手不放手的，我都查过了，周恒没有问题的。
Yes, it
did. 真的，你还不相信我吗？
Don't. I hope the photographer lady sends her that picture.
怎么这么黑啊？是不是停电了？
可能是关灯了吧。没事啊，慢点。
知道你喜欢这双鞋子很久了，幼仪，以后每一段路我都会陪你一起走。
谢谢你。
这位美女女士，可否请你跳一支舞啊？
今天晚上咱们的女主角就不要矜持了，先跳个舞吧。
Why do I feel it's just a big, yeah, I mean, big ruse to get her to? Forget about that gut feeling she had. I also want to wake up with a perfectly makeup face and perfect hair like that, because that happens. No.
小懒猪，该吃饭了。
She was probably up by 3 or 4 to fix all that and then went back to bed so she could look perfect when he found her. Actually, I know a lot of girls during this time actually did that and still kind of do, which is mind-blowing for me. They sneak up and like fix themselves so they will look perfect when their husband wakes up and see them. Why?
你下来了。先喝杯牛奶吧，早餐马上就好。
很快啊。
Is it gonna be the perfect husband now for like 5 minutes at least? Guess so.
We are 直接去会场吗？我衣服还没换呢。
放心吧，衣服都给你准备好了，现在去拿。还有配套的手套、包包、耳环、项链也都准备好了。
嗯，你最好了。
撒娇精。快起来，看看我给你准备的衣服。
嗯，
这可都是当下的最新款。你是喜欢浅蓝色还是橘黄色？
嗯，橘黄色吧。
不，相信我，你穿浅蓝色好看。
你都选好了，还来问我干嘛？
总要问一句的嘛。
好，好，好，听你的。
不许这样啊！一会儿啊，你可要穿着最漂亮的裙子。和如今上海滩最当红的影星跳今夜的开场舞，你不激动啊？
有什么好激动的？我又不是他的影迷。再说了，我也不觉得那位陈先生有多迷人啊，还不如我家周恒呢。
哟哟哟，又成你家的了啊？不疑神疑鬼啦？
不是你说他没问题的吗？我只是相信你。
这就对了，听我的，永远不会让你吃亏的啊。
嗯。
She is all the time.
夫人，先生交代让你先梳妆，晚点他过来接你一起去舞会。
好，你看，周恒多在意你啊，这是怕你被成双成迷倒，得紧紧守着你吧。去，走吧。
请问楚小姐，您的新书《为您在一起》主要讲述什么样的故事呢？
您说这个小说是为了纪念一场真实而禁忌的恋情，请问这是您的亲身体会吗？
对，是您的亲身体会吗？
是吧？少博大小姐，
是许攸怡小姐。
哎，
Yeah, the rivalry thing is going on there too. I mean, she's with her husband.
为什么呢？
因为今天晚上这双鞋特别的沉。
谢谢，这是我先生送我的生日礼物。
Yeah.
这双鞋当然不错了，
是 Lamy 设计师亲手打造的。
See?、嗯、
陈先生恐怕不知道吧。那是法国的一位著名的设计师。
陈先生，
那边有人叫我。
嗯哼，
先告辞。
She's not interested in him. She doesn't really care.
干嘛跟人家说话呀？人家又没得罪你。
我吃醋行不行？谁要等着他要给你跳舞啊？
我没有想到你还这么封建的。
幼姨，周恒，阿婉，
唱片公司的张经理在对面跟人吃饭呢，过去打个招呼。
他跟我们有合作吗？
现在没有，以后可不一定哦。我先过去了。
I think he likes orange, and that's why she told her not to wear orange. Because she's wearing orange a lot.
是吧？
啊？啊，是啊，他是你最好的朋友嘛。周公子，那位是银行的李部长，我过去跟你打个招呼，稍微离开一下好吗？
嗯，是吧？我又不是小孩子了，还跑丢了呀？
当然了，我视你如珠如宝。
是吧？
嗯，许小姐，这蛋糕特别不错，要不要我帮你拿一块尝一尝？
不用了，谢谢。
嗯，女性是要保持自己的仪态，毕竟你是上海的明星作家。
江探长，您没有公务要处理吗？不好意思，我对您的印象有点糟糕，总觉得你一出现可能没有好事要发生。
封建迷信，原来许小姐也是封建迷信啊，这样可不好。
I could understand that, and I think.
小姐，您先忙。
友谊是越来越漂亮了。
怎么样？就这样呗。
介绍姐姐好。
你没好看呐，
被爱情滋润的。
那是我呀，爱
情。我失陪一下。嗯，
快点回来。
快点回来。啊。
Oh, I love that window.I could probably watch this entire series and just watch, like, the aesthetic of it. It is so pretty. So, yeah. I'm thinking she saw Ben and her husband. No, because it's your husband.
别唱了。
怎么，你怕了？怕你了。
嗯哼。But it's good that you found out. I know, baby girl, I know. Breaking heart and all of that, but better to know than to have this feeling in the gut and not know why. Still went and danced with that celebrity guy. But yeah, your entire world is collapsing around you. And you're wondering how many people knew and never told you. You feel betrayed by your entire world right now, I guess. Okay, so that was Couple of Mirrors episode 1, and I'm intrigued. I love the aesthetics of it. I need to Google when Republic area was, because I'm getting 1920 vibes, but I'm also getting 1930s, 1940 vibes, but I don't know how the fashion was in China, if they were like a couple of years behind Europe, or, you know, when it comes to fashion and all of that, because the dress she had on in the beginning, that was absolutely 1920s here in Europe. But then there was one or two dresses that were more 1930s. Can you, yeah, I like historical clothing, okay? At least women's clothes. I wish I had the body to rock all those clothes, because, oh God, they are so pretty. But you know how expensive one is, like a real one. Not, I mean, not a vintage one, because I wouldn't dare have that, but like the same kind of craftsmanship with all the beading and... Don't get me started. Don't get me started. They are so expensive. So expensive. But yeah, so pretty. So pretty. So yeah, she found out that her husband was cheating with her best friend, and I think she feels betrayed by the entire world right now, because she's wondering who knew and how much did he knew and how much were they laughing behind her back, and you know, all of that. So I don't think she will trust anybody right now, not in her circle of friends. So she will probably look outside. And then we have the whole someone got killed and the detective, and I think we got a little bit of a murder mystery going on, and you know, all of that kind. So I'm so interested in where this is going, and this is a rather short series for being a Chinese. I think it's 12 episodes, so it's short, and normally a Chinese series is somewhere between 24 to 58 episodes. I think they have a cap that you are not allowed to be more than 50-ish episodes. China has a lot of rules about their television and what they can and cannot show, and like, I mean, come on people, time jump things are, or time travel things are kind of banned. And so yeah, because I don't know. So, but never mind that. It's a pretty short one. I think it's 12 episodes. I think there might be rumors about a season 2, but I don't know if there is coming. So yeah, I'm intrigued. I'm probably gonna watch the second episode a little bit later today. See where we're going, because I want to watch this some more. This was really, really, really good. And I'll talk to you next time.